Welcome to a new episode of Short Comic Introduction. Let me tell you a story. The story of a writer, his ghostly roommate, and how he tries to make not friends with a werewolf. Of course, I'm talking about the supernatural horror adventure comic Wilde Life by Pascalle Lepas. The comic started in September 2014 and already reached 6 chapters. And the story is about Oscar Wilde, like I said, a writer who rented a house in Oklahoma where he meets a ghost of a 1940 mathematician and everything that goes on. He soon finds out that his ghostly roommate is not the only supernatural thing he encounters. And the next part is, like I said, he meets a werewolf and all kinds of other, let's say, strange and supernatural things. The focus of the story is, it focuses around the stories of creatures from the Native American mythology. And that was something when I heard it at first, I didn't think it would work. I am a fan of different mythologies, but the stories I read, I have seen that some people really have problems, or let's say many writers have problems to make it in a way that it's not boring or overloaded with too much information about these let's say creatures from the mythology. So it was a little bit reducted when I started reading it, but I have to say after the start I really got into it after the part where Oscar meets Sylvia, the ghost in the house, because the way they meet was kind of a really funny way to tell the story, because it starts like your normal, let's say, your normal story part, where when someone sees a ghost, just runs screaming away. But in this case, yes, it starts this way, but 5 minutes later, he sits on his couch and talks with her, like he has a normal conversation with her, and the way it's written, it really got to me, and I really loved it. I loved the humor that came up, and that was when I saw we really have something special here on the plate, and it really went uphill from here, because everything that happened after that was really great written and fantastic framed from the pages. I love how Pascal balanced all the elements, the humor, the horror parts, the supernatural parts, and the intensity. So you could have in one frame or one page, you can have just a stroll through really great designed panels, and in the next there is you have the characters flee from something really bad, and it never loses focus. It's always really working. You have this the art works really great in this case. When there's something really extreme happening, the colors are really getting dark and eerie. The all mood and atmosphere is changing all from one panel to the next, and it never gets it never looks like it's something that doesn't belong here. You always you get this eerie feeling, let's say, when you're reading it, and it's really a thing that I appreciate in this comic. And also, like I said, the art, how she frames the pages, and how some panels are framed, is something I have to admit is works really great. And what I really admire is how sometimes there are these small details in these panels where you first don't look at, but or you don't see if you don't see at first, but when someone says there is something, or you look, let's say you look a little bit, you go to the next panel, and in the next moment you see from the corner of your eye that there's something a little bit different about this specific panel or picture, then you see the whole comic with other eyes. I don't want to go into spoilers too much in these small videos, because I like I always say, it's better to get the whole feeling when you don't know what you're reading or what you getting into. But let's just say a panel. You never thought a Coke machine can get this menacing in, let's say, a hospital corridor or something like that. And it's always, and you should always look at the page backgrounds when you read it, because sometimes even a normal picture in the background can make the whole panel to something special. And that's really something, like I said, I really appreciate. There are sometimes two or three times where I thought, that there was, let's say it a little bit differently. There are not many things I don't like about this comic, and there were only, I think, two or three times where I thought, yeah, that's the way that the story was told, or the jump to another character was a little bit abrupt, or should it work better when we haven't seen what happened in this specific part, but more what happened afterwards, when, let's say, the characters come back together. But that's just a small detail, and it's more the personal thing to say. It's not that it's bad. Like I said, the whole story, the whole framing, the whole way it's told. It's a really great comic, and I can just let's say, just try it out. If you are just a little bit into these mythology stories and creature stories, start reading it. I will guarantee that most of you will like this story and will want to know how it's going on. And I'm really looking forward where this whole story goes, because I want to know what's with all these supernatural things that happened specific to Oscar, why he is always somewhere in the middle of all this. And for me, it looks like there's more behind it than just coincidence, because the way, like I said, the story centers around him and how he encounters all these things, and we don't know why. For the moment, we don't know why he's really in this small town, and so. Like I said, I'm really looking forward to see more of this story, and hope it will go on for a while. And if you like it, like always, post in the comments, buy the book, be just tipper, or be a patron from her. So thanks for watching, and see you next time.